Let us discuss the electric field strength due to a large uniformly charged metal sheet. Here we are talking about a metal sheet because in the previous section we have studied the electric field due to a non-conducting sheet. And as we know, in case of a metal body, charges are mutually repelled and appear only on the outer surface of the conductor. So here also, if we have a metal sheet and some charge is given to it, it will spread on the front as well as rear surface of the sheet. And say here both of these surfaces have a surface charge density sigma coulomb per meter square. And in the situation in front of the sheet, say at a point P, we are required to find the electric field strength. And if we wish to use the Gauss law, we need to consider a surface, Gaussian surface, in such a way that at every point, electric field is either normal or parallel uniform, or as well as it will pass through point P. So, similar to the previous situation, here we consider a cylindrical Gaussian surface, but we do not extend it up to the other side symmetrically. We consider only up to the region which is between the two surfaces of the metal sheet, because here we know inside the metal sheet electric field is equals to zero. We could have extended it up to the section such that there is another point P which is symmetric to this point at the rear side of the surface, like we have done in the previous situation. But just to simplify, we consider the sheet up to this point, and in the situation if the surface area of the circular face of the cylinder is S, here we can see that enclosed charge within this Gaussian surface M will be only that of the front sheet. So, it will be sigma S. If you consider the Gaussian surface up to, which is extended up to the symmetric point at the rear side, then the total enclosed charge will be of both of these sheets, and we would have taken 2 sigma S. And in this situation, again, we divide the cylindrical surface in 3 parts, 1, 2, and this is third part. And here we can say that using Gauss law on surface M, we can write that the total flux through the surface M by integrating electric field for the surface must be equals to Q enclosed by epsilon naught. And in this situation, this integral can be split in 3 parts for the 3 surfaces. So, it is E dot ds for the first phase plus integration of E dot ds for the second phase plus integration of E dot ds for the third phase is equal to the enclosed charge in this surface is sigma s by epsilon naught we can use. And here you can see, for the phase 1 electric field due to the sheet in outward direction, as well as its area vector S will be in outward direction. For the phase 2 electric field is radial, but area vector at every point is in radially outward direction, which is perpendicular to the electric field at every point. So, in this situation we can say the dot product of electric field and surface area for the section 2 will vanish because these are normal to each other. For the section 3, as it is between the two surfaces of the sheet, or it is inside the volume, we know in a metal body inside the volume always field is 0, so this will also vanish. And for the phase 1, as E is uniform, we can write E integration of ds is sigma s by epsilon naught. And for this surface, which is parallel to the sheet and point P is also lying on it, the total area is S. It can be written as ES is sigma S by epsilon naught. Here S gets cancelled out, and the electric field can be written as sigma by epsilon naught, which is the electric field in front of a metal sheet on either side. Obviously, like here it is in this direction, on the rear side it will again be away from it. The magnitude of electric field strength is given as sigma by epsilon naught.